Yeah, so whose vehicle is this? And this was here last night. Like, this the weird stuff they do. I've been seeing them do this too. Like, they must go off somewhere that you park your vehicle with the car running, and then you go, like, I've seen in parking lots, like, it looked like nobody's in the vehicle though, and I hear music, and you're right by me. But this is petty stuff that I should ignore, but at the same time, y'all holler, y'all want evidence, and want to call me fake. And you hear the music? But yeah, I don't have a right to call the police or nothing. I mean, I'm so hypersensitive that even music at that volume bothers me. Yeah. There's a black fake gangster thug wearing red too. He just pulling off right now. A young ass kid. But tell me, y'all tell me I gotta have job skills and evidence. That I have to have job skills and evidence. I mean, what am I saying? Y'all saying I have to have skills in order to have a good job, but these degenerate, fake, uneducated, false gangsters, what kind of good job do they have that they driving around in nice new shit? And y'all act like y'all hating on me over a fucking, like, today on Twitter, the whole, not every single person, but a large amount of people in a so-called targeted individual tripping and ranting over over me over the time last week when I had a freaking $10 steak dinner at Texas Roadhouse that was $9.99, and you know, then everybody was tripping off of it and agreeing with that fake targeted individual perp who try to say, oh yeah, real TIs don't have steak dinners and beg for donations for hotel rooms and stuff. But then that's the same guy who said something the other day, like talking about that gang stalking is an illusion and all kinds of stuff like that. And then another person who professed to be a real targeted individual from New Zealand agreed with him. You know, so it's like I had to go on a freaking massive blocking spree today. You know, so like, how the hell are you going to talk about what real TIs do? And then you don't even and then you sit there and say that gang stalking is illusion. Pick one. So, I mean, oh, shucks, I'm in the bathroom and accidentally filming the toilet and everything. What the hell am I doing? So, I mean, I don't know. I just don't know. I just felt so beat up today on Twitter. And then a few other people got, you know, snappy and with an attitude towards me and stuff like that, you know. I just don't freaking understand what's so bad or wrong about me. You know, what am I doing? You know? And I don't know. I'm just, like as if I'm supposed to just not have a right to be happy. Like, y'all want me to be locked up in a mental institution when I'm crying But then when I'm happy, you try to block that too. Pick one, you know? So, I mean, I am not living it up like that. You know, falsely accusing me of just living it up and freeloading and having a good time off of other people's money, which is not damn true. And I know what I go through. I know I suffer the damn vibrating. You just saw what the guy did. He was wearing red. And, you know, so, I mean, you're telling me I better have evidence and I can't just go around saying stuff or making claims. All right. But then you sit there and tell me I need to ignore the gang stalkers. Which one, you know? So, I mean, when I posted that, you know, one headlight, gang stalker waiting for me, and I said, this person is guilty of murder. This person is a murderer. And then another person said, be careful of making claims like this and not having evidence and stuff like that. I'm like, so why, how come people, how come the gang stalkers, nobody tells them be careful about what they say about us and not have evidence. They just slander us and make up lies and everything. And it's like, you want me to be, you know, super, you know, it's like, a lot of us targeted individuals have said, you know, gang stalking cunts or gang stalking fags or gang stalking dykes or gang stalking whores or whatever. But when it comes to me saying something like that, oh, you they have every right to sue you for libel and slander, and you can't just go around saying stuff like that about people. And, you know, but it's like, if I expose the Freemasons and calling somebody a Masonic whore, I mean, why do I need evidence if they, y'all know the damn rituals that they do, you know, y'all know what they're capable of and what they're susceptible to doing, you know, but nobody says that, nobody gets on the gang stalkers. I mean, even if somebody's slandering the target, the other target, and that target would be like, you know, if a gang stalker is slandering me, they say, oh, just ignore them. But then when it comes to me, oh, you better make sure you have your evidence and you can't just go around making claims like that, you know. So when people try to call me a fake targeted individual, where's my right to sue them for slander and libel? You know, when I have my proof, you just saw it. And the guy was a black fake gangster wearing red. And there was another vehicle parked in that exact spot earlier. So, I'm not getting my peace up in here. You know, I think that was a freaking gang stalking move to put me in a room with the bathroom with blood on the handlebars right here. You know? So, I mean, or maybe it wasn't, I don't know, but it's like, all those times they cheat me out my food, you know, I don't know, I'm just really frustrated, and going back to that moment again, that I had such a rough freaking day, that I'm sitting here contemplating cutting off all forms of social functioning, online and in person. But when I do that, they gang stalk me even worse. They attack me even worse. And I noticed that when I get into it with another targeted individual, I say profess because whether they're real or fake, every time I have an altercation with another targeted individual, they gang stalk me even worse, and I end up having almost a breakdown and stuff like that. So, again, why should do targeted individuals keep oppressing and abusing each other and giving each other a hard time? You know, people talking about, you better make sure you have your evidence. And those are the main people giving me thumbs down when I show the color harassment, when I show the noise harassment. Y'all wanted me to shut up a couple of months ago when I was at Janet's house and I was exposing the my noise harassment experiences, y'all kept thumbing down all those videos and getting mad at me and calling me aggravating and stuff. But now y'all keep wanting your evidence, wanting your evidence, wanting your evidence. And then when I do, you want to tell me, ignore! So I'm getting the fuck off of here and fuck society. Just the hell. That everybody needs to throw themselves in the fucking toilet.